Welcome back, everybody, to Weather Animations. Today, we look at the 2002 Atlantic hurricane season, where 14 tropical depressions formed, 12 of which were storms, 4 reaching hurricane status, and 2, the unprecedented major hurricane status. In total, there were 50 fatalities and $2.5 billion in damages. So please sit back, relax, and watch as this 2002 Atlantic hurricane season unfolds. We start this 2002 Atlantic hurricane season off with Tropical Storm Arthur, formed on the 14th and dissipated on the 16th as a tropical storm, where it was a subtropical storm and ran into Newfoundland. It did proceed northward from there without causing any more harm. From there, we move on to Bertha, which formed off Louisiana coast, barely gaining tropical storm status before running into land there. Did meander there for a little while before re-emerging off the coast of Louisiana and running towards Texas. Luckily, it never regained tropical storm status in the process. After that, we have Tropical Storm Chrisball, which formed on August 5th and proceeded towards the southeast, reaching a maximum intensity of 50 miles an hour and not doing much from there. After that, we have Tropical Storm Dolly. Again, not much to speak of from here as it was a fish storm. It did reach a maximum intensity of 60 miles an hour, tying it for the most intense storm thus far this season. We have Tropical Storm Edouard, which formed off the coast of Florida. Again, not reaching a very strong intensity at only 65 miles an hour, so therefore not hurricane status. Did meander there for a little while before making landfall in Florida. It did reemerge out the other side of Florida, but has not yet gained tropical storm status again. After that, we have Tropical Storm Fay, which formed in the northwestern Gulf of Mexico, making landfall in southeastern Texas. Next, we have Tropical Depression 7, which did not reach tropical storm status. After which we have Gustav, which was our first hurricane of the season, peaking in intensity at 100 miles an hour. But before that, it made a close approach to the Outer Banks of North Carolina before speeding off towards the north and east, finally reaching hurricane status, briefly category 2, and making landfall in Newfoundland. After that, we have Tropical Storm Hanna, forming in the Gulf of Mexico. Did meander around for a little while, but it did make an approach towards Louisiana and Alabama and Mississippi, where it made landfall. Afterwards, we have Isidore, which was our most impactful storm of the season, formed on September 14th. It was our first major hurricane of the season, reaching peak intensity at 125 miles an hour, which is category 3 status. Minimum essential pressure was 934 millibars. Here we see it finally reaches hurricane status south of Cuba, and it did run into the western, extreme western part of Cuba. Did slow down a little while as it reached the Yucatan Peninsula, where caused most of its damages for rolling inland and losing its hurricane status. Did emerge, though, as a tropical storm, where it continued northward towards Louisiana yet again, where it made landfall. Next, we have short-lived Tropical Storm Josephine, only reaching 40 mile an hour peak intensities. Next, we have Hurricane Kyle, which formed way out in the open ocean of the Atlantic. It meandered around for a little while, barely a tropical storm, before finally picking its southwestward trajectory, where it did reach its maximum intensity. It'll be a little while before we get there, but we will eventually reach land. So please watch until then, and I'll pick back up with you at that time. As you can see, Kyle continued to meander around a little bit here before finally moving again in its new trajectory. Again, Kyle found a way to meander around yet again before plummeting towards the south and west and then making a curve back towards the north and east. Not before making very close approach to land as a tropical depression, barely a tropical storm. Did make landfall though in South Carolina. Lili was our next hurricane of the season, and it was the strongest one of this 2002 Atlantic hurricane season. It reached a peak intensity of 145 miles an hour, which sits it nicely in category 4 status. It did remain a tropical storm for a little while here, and struggling at that, it had to go back to a tropical depression for a little while before regaining its tropical storm strength near Cuba, Hispaniola, and Jamaica. It meandered around those islands for a little while before finally reaching hurricane status and rapidly intensifying into its category 4 nature. And it reached Louisiana, which has been hit several times this hurricane season. It made landfall as a category 1 hurricane. Finally, we have our last tropical depression of the season. And with this, I would like to thank you all for watching. And if you like videos like this, want me to speak over more of my videos in this way, please hit the like button and subscribe to this channel for more videos like this. I appreciate your support and have a great day.